I'm a Notion fanboy, but I have to admit there are some reasons why Obsidian is actually better than Notion. I'm gonna dive into the top five reasons as to why that's the case in this video. First and foremost, your data is your data. If you go into Obsidian, all of this is basically just locally stored data that is inside of your file storage on your computer. Now there is Obsidian Sync, which is a sync application so that you can sync it between like your phone and your computer, and there's Obsidian Publish. But the data itself is yours, and the export functionality is great in Notion. If I were to try to export anything, it'd be hard, as well as the fact that all of my information is just stored on Amazon Web Services that is not my own. In the app data section on my computer, this is where all of the different files are actually stored for Obsidian. It's not like it's on cloud storage, it's my data. I'm not stuck with my data on another platform trying to get it off of there. I have all of my data for myself, I can export it, and that's the first reason. The second reason is its simplicity. I think that the simplicity that Obsidian has is a little bit better than Notion, because there are a lot of really annoying things that happen. Like, watch this, I can create a page in Obsidian in a second. I can delete it just as easily. What is a problem with Notion is the fact that if I want to do anything like that, or take this page and open it in a new pane, I just don't have that same capability to easily interact with the application, because Notion is just a little bit slower. And that's because it has so much going on. This is literally just text pages, and I've added some community plugins, which I'll get into later, but it doesn't overwhelm you with a bunch of different databases and things. Like, if we look here at a page, right? If I do / timeline, and this is, you know, it's timeline view, I can take anything here. Change this view to a timeline. Who uses timeline views in Notion? It was a nice addition, but like, there's just so much stuff going on that you're going to have a bloated software. Now, the information linking in Obsidian is better than Notion. So just from this graph view here, you can see that there are a lot of different things that can be connected. Basically, if you do any sort of backlinking, like this is an example that I had, right, where I linked running shoes to the professional running page, and then another one here was the running shoes page linked back to the professional runners and all those sort of things. The backlinking that you can do between these different things lets you have the amazing graph view where all of these different things, if I were to have different books go together or different concepts in general, where I had a bunch of notes on professional runners and then I had a bunch of notes on training and shoes, all that connecting with each other would be a nice thing to look at. And then I could even have specific runners and the professional runners branch off. Like if I had this turn into Matthew Centrowitz, make another note for Matthew Centrowitz, right? It would make sense from a data visualization standpoint that Matthew Centrowitz would branch off the professional runners. And that would be something really cool to look at. And that's another reason that Obsidian's better. It just has better visualization of notes and how they go together. Another really great reason is that it has something like Obsidian Publish. So Obsidian Publish is the awesome functionality of Obsidian, but on a published format that you can go and interact with, and it can be used as a public daily journal. If we look at this, this is my friend Denny Hatcher, who has a really nice Obsidian Publish page where he has his daily journal for all to see here, and it's using the really cool functionality of Obsidian, and it even has that nice interactive graph view for you to go along with. There's a table of contents that he made for us, a quick guide showing just the different parts of it, like the journal folder, his capture notes, his working notes, and I really think that it's nice to have all of these capabilities in an application for you to showcase your audience. Now, from a community plugin standpoint, this application has a litany of them. If we go into this and browse the different plugins, there are a bunch of different ones that I haven't even installed, but you can go through and add a calendar to the top right of your Obsidian, which I've done, adding the Kanban board view, which is really cool. And actually having templates is something that I'm probably gonna install, because that's something I wanna get into as well. But the community plugins are awesome, because this application is continuously being improved on by the community, and good old GitHub is making it happen. So as you can see here, there is a to-do list that I've implemented into Obsidian. There is a calendar I've implemented into Obsidian. And all of this just goes along with the amazing improvements that this application has made. And it's a two-person team that started Obsidian and still has it going. And I'm just beyond impressed at what they've been able to do. There's even a syncing my Kindle highlights that I've had on the clippings. So like when I was reading Marcus Aurelius, there were some things that I wanted to highlight, and I have all of my clippings here in Obsidian as well. It's amazing to have these different types of things. As someone who's constantly been trying to improve his productivity, this is an application I really want to learn and dive into in this year. And I hope you actually check out this one too to see how you can improve your productivity even more.